Hello, everyone. I'm Dr. Christina Muzny, Associate Professor of Medicine, Epidemiology, and Obstetrics and Gynecology in the Division of Infectious Diseases at the University of Alabama at Birmingham. Bacterial vaginosis, which is often referred to as BV for short, is an important and common cause of vaginal discharge among women worldwide. In this mini lecture, I'll provide a brief overview of one proposed hypothetical model for the pathogenesis of BV, which is a complex process involving significant changes in the vaginal microbiome. This model is based on an extensive review of the literature, in addition to data generated by my research team. In a healthy state, the vaginal microbiome is dominated by lactic acid and hydrogen peroxide producing lactobacillus species, which lowers the vaginal pH and protects the environment against invading pathogens and pathobionts. The abundant vaginal lactobacilli produce lactic acid and other metabolites, which lower the vaginal pH. In this lactobacillus-dominant microbiota, the vaginal epithelial cells produce antimicrobial peptides and anti-inflammatory cytokines. The conditions created in this healthy vaginal environment protect against invading pathogens and pathobionts. Vaginal dysbiosis begins with initial colonization by a virulent strain of Gardnerella vaginalis or other Gardnerella species, a microaerophilic and facultative anaerobe. This colonization typically follows a sexual exposure. Gardnerella, unlike other BV-associated bacteria, which are strict anaerobes, can tolerate the high redox potential of a lactobacillus-dominated vaginal microbiota. These newly colonizing Gardnerella bacteria are then able to displace the protective lactobacilli and adhere to vaginal squamous epithelial cells. As the number of Gardnerella species expands, they generate a lower-level BV biofilm that allows other opportunistic bacteria to grow on the vaginal mucosa. Next, Prevotella bivia joins Gardnerella vaginalis on the vaginal epithelium in the lower layers of the BV biofilm. Prevotella bivia is another common BV-associated bacteria that is acquired from maternal and/or environmental sources. It is normally present in very low concentrations in the vaginal microbiome. Gardnerella vaginalis and Prevotella bivia have a well-established symbiotic and synergistic relationship. For example, proteolysis by Gardnerella vaginalis produces amino acids that enhance Prevotella bivia growth, and ammonia produced by Prevotella bivia stimulates Gardnerella vaginalis growth. Vaginal sialidase, produced by BV-associated bacteria, including Gardnerella vaginalis and Prevotella bivia, promotes breakdown of the mucus layer on the vaginal epithelium. Vaginal sialidase is a proteolytic carboxylase enzyme. At this point, the number of lactobacilli have markedly declined and the vaginal pH has increased. Loss of the protective mucus layer on the vaginal epithelium leads to increased adherence of other BV-associated bacteria, such as Faniessa vaginae and Synethia species, amongst others, which join the BV biofilm, leading to the formation of a mature polymicrobial entity. Some of these secondary colonizers to the BV biofilm, particularly Faniessa vaginae and Synethia species, can stimulate a strong host immune response from vaginal epithelial cells, leading to localized cytokine and beta defensin production. This host immune response may contribute to the symptoms of BV that women experience, as well as adverse health outcomes. In symptomatic BV, exfoliation of vaginal epithelial cells coated with polymicrobial biofilm occurs, and these cells, which are commonly referred to as clue cells, can be seen on a wet mount of vaginal secretions. Production of biogenic amines and metabolites increase in the vaginal pH and may contribute to clinical symptoms, including a fishy vaginal odor and a clear to milky white vaginal discharge. The presence of a characteristic vaginal discharge, fishy vaginal odor, elevated vaginal pH, and clue cells visible on a wet mount comprise the four main AMSL criteria for making a diagnosis of BV in the clinic. I hope this mini lecture has provided you with a better understanding of our proposed model for the pathogenesis of bacterial vaginosis. This model continues to be a work in progress, and changes may be made in the future based on new research. I'd like to thank three of my colleagues, particularly who helped contribute to this model and this project: Paul Lineski, Jane Schwebke, and Melissa Herbst-Krovelitz. Thank you.
The production of this National STD Curriculum mini-lecture was supported by funding from the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention,